Okay, so today's video is all about using AI as a sort of a data analyst to do calculations and analysis on top of CSV files. So let's imagine that we have five CSV files, and these are all about electric vehicle data in the state of Washington. And here's just one example of a file. It's a bunch of registration of electric vehicles in different counties, but there are other files, and some of them are big. This one here is, I think, about 50 megabytes and 200,000 rows, and some of them are smaller. And some of these are relevant to the question we want to ask, and some of them are not relevant. And the question we want to ask is, what's the county with the most growth in EVs? And what is the most popular current EV make and model there, and the number of cars of that make and model? So what the model would have to do is first it has to identify which files are relevant to the question, because some files are going to be relevant, some files are not. Then it's going to need to find the county with the most growth. And then it needs to go and for that county, find the most popular EV make and model and return the number of cars for that make and model. So let's go ahead and ask it to do that. This is going to take about 45 seconds or so. So I'm just going to pause the video and I'm going to come right back. Okay. And it returned that the county with the most growth is Clark. The most popular make and model is Tesla Model Y. And here's the number of cars of that make and model in Clark County. So why is this important? I mean, a good data analyst could probably also do this analysis pretty quickly. And this doesn't seem like a major value add. But it becomes much more important if you have a lot of data. So some companies have thousands or tens of thousands of these files. And this kind of logic can also work with a much larger number of files. And then the work that AI is doing is finding that relevant data and then doing analysis on top of that data. And how does it work under the hood? So for this particular use case, we're using OpenAI and we're using their assistance API. So this is not the chat API, the chat completions API, which is the basic kind of ask a question, get an answer API. This is a little bit more sophisticated. And the way it differs is it's just like the chat API, but you add some additional capabilities on top of the chat API. The two specific capabilities that we're adding here is one, the model can reference files. So that's what we're using to allow it to reference these files. And right now it can reference up to 100,000 files. In this case, we're having it reference five files. And then the second thing is it can use code and it can specifically use Python to run calculations. So when we ask this question, what AI is doing is it's figuring out, okay, I need to run some Python code on these files. Here's the Python code I'm going to run. I'm going to run that code and I'm going to return the results. And that's all feasible because of the use of the assistance model. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that AI is not good enough to do very complex analysis yet. So if the question I was asking was a lot more complex, I wouldn't rely on AI to return the right answer. But this is all constantly improving, and it's pretty feasible that in a year or two, AI will be able to do pretty sophisticated analysis similar to what a data analyst might do. So that's using AI for data analysis, and until next time.